and welcome back to my channel. Please, I know you maybe have seen me with this dress. I used one stone to kill two birds, all right? So yeah, there's one video I did, sit down video about business ideas, stay at home moms, all right? So I said, okay, since I have time, let me just do this story. I just want to do my pregnancy story, my delivery story. Okay, let's start. You know, normally you have to miss your period, right? Before they say, okay, you're pregnant, okay? So, yeah, I missed my period. So, we now went to the hospital to confirm that I'm pregnant. So, in that hospital, and I registered for my antenatal, okay? So, when I registered, yeah, I started going for my antenatal every month. I started going every month. So, when my baby was 4 months, so when we went for the 4 month checkup and scan, that was my first scan, 4 months. So in that same hospital, they now said I have fibroid. Hey, God, I was mad. My whole world collapsed. I was like, what? Me? How? God. I started crying. Even that day, our plan was, me and my husband were like, okay, after going for the scan, let's just hang out. Because my first trimester was hell. I literally, if I eat, I'll just vomit. You know, I'll just throw up. So my first one was not. So my fourth month, I was having this. I was enjoying my pregnancy. So that very day, when we now went to the hospital, I said, okay, half my blood, God. But before I even continue, I want to tell you that what God cannot do does not exist. I know you are hearing this, but I want to tell you that no matter what you are going through, maybe you are trying to conceive, just keep on praying. One day God will answer you. So after that day, though they said the problem was very small. And it's outside my womb, and it's very small. And it's small, they say it's small like pea, you know, pea, like green pea or so. So like, God, me, how? I've not even thought of it, I've not even imagined it. Okay, we started going. I was not feeling any pain. Though they told me, doctor, analyze everything to me that in some point I might feel pain, all those stuff. But that 4 months, when my baby was so small. See, my baby was weighing 1.something kg. That was so small or something. I was angry because of the fiber. I think maybe if I'm eating, the food is being shared, you know, that kind of thing. So I was like, how me? So at the time, I started praying about it. We prayed, we consulted our pastors, we were praying. My brother that is a medical doctor, I called him, I told him, see what's happening. He now said, I should not bother myself. That is nothing. Now it's nothing. Why am I crying? Hey, people was not talking to me. That I should not bother. That is nothing. We continue the journey. So at the time, okay, they now said I should be eating. I should be very careful what I eat. I should make sure that I eat healthy. So that's why I'm so good at, you know, smoothies. Like even till now. So I was so used to smoothies, green smoothies. As I changed my food, I changed my milk to coconut milk. I made sure that everything I was eating so healthy. I stopped eating noodles. And so I make sure that I was running away from carbohydrates, you know, that kind of stuff. So I will make sure my baby, I should have heard that my baby is here. So, okay, at the time, one day like that, I finished taking tea. That was in the night, around 11. I finished taking tea with Milo. So that was the last time I stopped taking Milo, you know. So I was taking tea with Milo. So after the tea, I started having this kind of sharp pain. When I mean sharp, I couldn't even walk. And my baby was six months there. I could not even walk. What is happening? And I said, okay. I told my husband, I cannot even enter this until tomorrow. Let's go. That was at 11. We now rushed to that same hospital. Thank God the hospital school goes to us. We now rushed to the hospital. They were so good. The doctor was there. Not they were so good. Then they checked my fire, everything. They gave me drip injection. It was not up to 1 hour, depends of style. I felt good, nothing. So that's how we started going. 6 months, 7 months, nothing. Everything was okay. After that, that time they went to the hospital, I didn't even feel anything again. You know, me, I used to hear people be saying you'll be feeling pain, your stomach will be very big, like you have 2 minutes. My tummy was just normal, like a normal person that having one baby, you know, that kind of stuff. So we started praying, though. Everything, we are praying about it. Do me, and I say, God, let this not disturb my baby. Another kind of stuff. Let it not disturb my baby. So we started going every day. Because of that, we're not doing check. We're not doing scan every month. You know, we're not doing scan every month. The hospital I went, they were so good. All those stuff. So, my baby was dead 40 weeks. The baby don't even want. My baby don't want to come out. So the nurse said I should come on 28 for induction. So when I went on 28, so that they reduced me. So we went early, they said we should come early by 8. By 8, we were there. So we went early by 8. So they started the process, you know, they gave me drip. I was not even feeling anything, nothing else. I was just there. Ha! At the time, at around 12, 11, I saw blood, like something water. You know that they say the water broke. So it's not small thing, it's not if it broke like broke, small water. So I was like, hey, I went to my house, see what is happening. I was taking hot water. My husband was giving me hot water. At the time, the pain was intense. When I mean intense, they either come and insert their hand to check how many centimeters have been related, all those stuff. Hey, I'll be crying. I was not telling my husband, sweet, it happened when you get that way, sweet, oh, hey, oh, this is how I'll be crying. This is before, it's not that it was not funny. My hair, I made the house in the morning. I said, sweet, this here, let's do this here. This here is hot. Hey, everywhere is hot. Let me go outside, though. Hey, oh, this is how I was doing. Hey, the pain was intense. Throughout that day, nothing happened. When they checked me, I was just 4 centimeters. There, nothing happened throughout that day. The next day, it continued. So, what they did, the next day in the afternoon, they were checking me. They were taking my temperature, taking my baby's heartbeat, check every me. They were checking me, giving me drug, giving me food. The food safe. That I started shivering. Started for me. I could not even eat. I lost appetite. I could not even eat. So after everything, so that day, the next day. After that, nothing happened. I was just forcing them. Nothing happened. So the next day, my husband. All this I'm saying, if you see the kind of cry, my husband was massaging my back with hot water. I think, honey, hey, I'll just be, hey. Anytime my husband wants to sleep, the thing will come. Anytime my husband will see me, hey, I will shout. Hey, whoa, the whole house was yelling my voice. If you see me that time, I was naked now. I was just putting on the hospital clothes. The hospital was, I was not even seeing anybody. The pain was too much. I was not even seeing anybody. So, even my parents, they are so scared for me because they know that kind of person. When I was growing up, I'm a kind of fragile person. Any small thing, I'm just fragile in the house. So everybody was scared of, they're scared for me, you know. So everybody was calling, my mommy was calling, everybody video call, they will call. So at the time, so the doctor now came. That was the next. This is the afternoon, the next day. Doctor now came. Doctor now used her hand and broke the water everywhere. Water. Even I was using that ball to, nothing was working for me. When I did not, this, hey God, I said, what is happening? The pain was too much. I think maybe because, why the pain was too much? Because of the fibroid, okay? So, at the time, we are still praying. So, around 4, the main doctor or something like that came. That was a man, because the woman is a gynecologist that was attending to me. And I said I should go upstairs. I was like, when I went upstairs, they started shaving me. Okay, they said, I did not tell anything. So now I called my husband and said, this is true, almost 24 hours, nothing is happening. So let's do CS. So my husband now said, okay, give her some time. They should give me some time. Maybe that was 11, 4 o'clock. So my husband now said, okay, let them give me so like 2 hours. If nothing happens in 2 hours, they should carry her. Okay. I was not crying. My sister will call me on video call. Hey, my sister started crying for me because the way I was even, my sister said she used to hear all this, but she don't even know that is. Hey, I was like, God, what is happening? So the pain was too much. How can I say, sweet, I want to die. Sweet, she said, sweet, I said, wait here now, mommy now. Hey, hey God. Oh my God. So around 4, so this will happen around 6:30 or so. Till now started. They said I should push, okay? Push. I was like, did not come out. I will do it again. This is you see the head now. And one good thing is that they allowed, I assume I'm a YouTuber, then I'll just video everything because they allowed my husband in there with even our camera. My sister was calling, everyone was calling video because they were seeing me. They allowed my husband inside the room. My husband was there inside the room. My husband holding my hand, rubbing my head. My husband said, mommy, you are strong. We can do it. My husband was talking to me. My husband, God bless you. If you see the kind of encouragement she was telling me, I don't have any, my mother is not, my father is not, my husband was my father, my, as in, it was everything. Ha, God. And I said, okay. When they were telling me push, my husband said, then I told my husband, see all babies here. My husband said, mommy, look, she won't again. My sister said, oh, she's not throwing much. You are lying to me. That's what I said, you are trying. Keep on. Ha, I pushed. Next one I had, bam, bam. They gave me tea. I don't even feel any pain because the pain I was even feeling. I don't even feel any pain. What the hell? Bam, bam, like they gave me tea. If it's my baby, I will send the picture. If you see my baby here, maybe 4.8 kg. Maybe it's big. To get some my baby, I didn't even, when my baby came, I didn't even feel it. Someone said, see your baby now. Hey, I was like, God, am I dreaming? Am I dreaming? So immediately they now carry my baby to go and clean her up. My husband now went there. So they were not stitching me, you know, that kind of. So they gave me a dish. I didn't even that stitch, I don't even feel anything. So they asked to clean me. They were cleaning me up. Then my husband was in my baby in the other room. They were cleaning her, taking care of her. My sister that is not even called. You know, when my sister called, so they were talking. As soon as I was with people there, hey, I'm just if the video like I'm going to do it, hey. The video I'm gonna have done then, hey God, because it will be rough, because they allow my husband in the room to even do video call. They were so free with them. You know, we are fine that they will just be taking care of us, like, hey. So when my baby came out, that was what happened. They teach me, I just managed, you know, and that kind of hospital, they say you're not leaving. You stay there for 2 nights and 3 days. So we stayed there for 2 nights, 3 days. You have to monitor my baby to check everything. All this stuff. So that was actually what happened. So my baby, you know, that's the best. My best didn't start running immediately. So we started with formula for 2 days before we leave. We left on Monday. My baby was born on Sunday, 15 minutes after 7. We left on Tuesday morning. Yeah, that was it. That was what happened. So after 3-6 weeks, you know, the 6 week checkup, that's when they have to do, they scan me to check everything. Do you know what God did to me? The Bible, like, we did not see it again. How? God, it's not gone. Is this gone not wonderful? We did not see it again. After the 6 week checkup, my baby was fine, everyone was fine. So this is a kind of encouragement to everyone. My dear, keep praying. God will answer one day, okay? I hope you enjoyed this story or this little story. I don't know how to tell story, you can just manage it, okay? I hope you enjoyed this little story of mine. Yeah. So that's actually my labor and delivery story, okay? Pregnancy, fibroid, labor and delivery story. I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to like, share, don't skip the ads, okay? And turn notification bell when you subscribe. So whenever I post, you don't get to miss my video. See you in my next one. Bye.